Yes, sir. So, good morning, everyone. Today, I'll be presenting my free paper on modified MIOCT guided management of submacular bleed in cases of polypoidal choroidal vasculopathy. It's a novel technique that Dr. Atul Kumar has developed. So, we have no financial interest or we have no financial disclosure or conflict of interest. So, as we all know, submacular hemorrhage is accumulation of blood between the RPE and the neurosensory retina. It can be due to various causes, and the causes can be as high as AMD, polypoidal choroidal vasculopathy, myopia, trauma, or angioid streaks. And basically, it has got poor prognosis if not dealt in time. And mechanism of vision loss is basically shearing effect on photoreceptors and toxicity due to elevated iron levels and scarring. So there is already in the literature various techniques for the management of submacular hemorrhage, such as pneumatic displacement, fibrinolysis, anti-VEGFs, and surgeries are nowadays not that preferred. But we know that in polypoidal choroidal vasculopathy, it's a slow-growing BVN complex with aneurysmal dilatations, and we as an Asian ancestry are more prone to have PCV as compared to AMD, and these are also more prone to have massive recurrent and sub-RP and subretinal hemorrhages. So basically, various techniques have been described in the literature for the management of vision-threatening submacular hemorrhage, but the surgical management of PCV related submacular hemorrhage needs to be extensively studied. And with the advent of MIOCT, real-time imaging is available. So it gives us better clinical judgment, as well as it gives us better real-time update of the procedure that we are doing. So we will be, I'll be showing you video of a modified technique in which we did past planar vitrectomy for some large submacular hemorrhages, in which we did past planar vitrectomy, followed by submacular injection of cocktail of recombinant tissue
plasminogen activator.
At the end of the surgery, gas tamponade was given using SF6. Operatively, propped up position was given. So here, as we can see,
presentation is
involving till the vascular arcades and the center of the fovea. Past planar vitrectomy was done, core vitrectomy was done, PVD was induced using tricot. Then, then with the help of IOCT, we identified the areas of hemorrhages, the areas in which the height of the hemorrhage was largest, and we can see the areas of pigment epithelial detachment below that. So basically, we don't have to inject in areas of PED. So with the help of IOCT, we can easily distinguish areas of high areas of bleed having highest height, and the areas of PED also, which are sometimes difficult to see. And then we injected it with the cocktail, and at the last you can see air also going subretinally. So basically, this cocktail displaces the bleed, liquefies the clot, and the Avastin in the cocktail reduces the risk of re-bleed by tackling the BVN. So it acts on three ways, and at the end there is fluid air exchange, and then tamponade was given using SF6, and we give propped up position. So in normal position, like if we give intravitreal C3F8 or intravitreal gas with RTPA, we have to give sometimes prone position to the patient to displace the bleed. But here, as the bleed is already displaced, so the patient is very free to use propped up position. It will also help in clearing of the blood. So this was like the one of the pre-op patients with a large submacular hemorrhage, and post-operatively his submacular bleed got resolved and his vision improved from finger counting close to face to 6x9 at 6 months visit. So we did a prospective international interventional study, including 20 eyes of 20 patients. These all eyes underwent the same procedure, and patient lay propped up for the post-operative period, and post-operative follow-up was done till 6 months, which is the highest till date. And we have found that baseline characteristics, most of the patients were old, and average duration of the patient symptoms was around 8 to 15 days. Baseline BCVA was very poor due to submacular hemorrhage, finger counting or hand movement close to face. Center of fovea was involved in all the cases on OCT, and 8 cases have large vascular hemorrhages extending to vascular arcades. So we found that in our using our technique, complete displacement of hemorrhage from macula was noted in all cases. The average time for resolution of bleed was around 7.6 weeks, which goes well with the literature. and the BCVA improved from 1.64 at the baseline, 2.82 logMAR units at 6 months of follow-up, and all these were statistically significant, p-value less than 0.04. So at the last, I want to conclude by saying that favorable outcomes can be achieved using our modified technique, and they are basically achieved due to effective liquefaction and displacement of bleed, as well as simultaneous treatment of underlying pathologies such as branch vascular network. And IOCT helps in precise delivery of drug, avoiding any inadvertent injection into areas of PED. Thank you.
Very nice presentation, Dr. Divya. May I have one question?
Yes, sir.
Dr. Divya, you have used intraoperative OCT for this.
Yes, sir.
For this study, you have used the intraoperative OCT. Suppose
yes, sir.
If someone is not having the intraoperative OCT, suppose I am not having the intraoperative OCT, I have to take the patient at 10 o'clock in the OT for the surgery, can I do multiple scan in my OPD room in the OCT with the OCT and find out where the largest site of the macular hemorrhage is there?
Yes, sir. You can very well do. You can very well use a preoperative OCT, but sometimes due to extensive hemorrhage, if the penetration of the OCT is not that much, then sometimes it is difficult to say in which area there are pigment epithelial detachments, but you can very well use pre-op OCTs as well. The idea of my paper was not to highlight the inexplicable role of IOCT, but also to highlight the technique, sir. In our technique, we use subretinal cocktail of three drugs, which is very important for the management of PCV. IOCT's role is additional.
Okay. That's good.
Did you face any complication in your series? Were there any complications post-operative period?
Sir, luckily, we didn't face any major complication. In two of our cases, the bleed got breakthrough into the vitreous cavity because we didn't make any hole or retinotomy to drain the bleed. So when we displaced it away from the fovea using creating artificial detachment, in two cases where the bleed was large, it got dispersed into vitreous to a paramacular hole. So that also helped to clear the bleed, and it sealed off on its own, and the patient vision was improved on propped up position, sir. The bleed
Thank
got
you.
Resolved
Thank
with propped up position only.
Okay. Thank you very much. Very nice presentation.
Thank you.